Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. So what are we talking about here today? Well, it's one of my favorite things, a guitar neck exercise. And you guys know that I believe this is something that you cannot skip out on, because if you don't understand your guitar neck, how are you ever going to be proficient at rhythm and lead guitar? And I know that learning one of your favorite songs or practicing a guitar solo is perhaps more fun, but neck learning doesn't have to go by the wayside. So in this lesson, we're going to learn a quick exercise that won't take you more than about 2 minutes, and you'll get better at locating your notes both on the neck as well as on a sheet of traditional music notation paper, the music staff. So let's get things started by grabbing a sheet of staff paper and establishing a note along with a preset range to work in. Start with one note. That note will be your primary tone. We're going to use the note of A, and we'll have it be the A note that sits on the second space of the music staff. And from that note, move through the other 7 tones of the musical alphabet and write them all down on a piece of sheet music paper. Now, underneath, write their names. And over top of the notes, write their numbers from 1 to 8, root to octave. Once you have the notes written on the music staff, the next thing you'll want to do is locate those notes on the guitar neck. But when you're doing this, also keep in mind that the music staff is a representation of the range of the pitches. So if we're focused on using mid-range tones, those tones will be more in the middle of the guitar string sets or in the middle of the fretboard. So let's use the neck generator over at Guitar Scientist's website to lay out the tones that we wrote out on the music staff, and we'll get those notes placed onto the guitar fingerboard. So to get started, the first thing you'll want to do is go to guitarscientist.com/generator, and you're going to get this great guitar fingerboard here that you can work on. Once you're here, the next thing I want you to do is to click on the notation button, and we're going to turn on the show note names function. Now remember, we're dealing right now with mid-staff note layout. So when we go to the guitar fingerboard, those notes aren't going to be down low like a low open A or a low A on the 6th string 5th fret. They're going to be more in the middle of the fingerboard. So you do have another A right here, and there's another A on the 4th string at the 7th fret. So those would be the one of those two A's would be the one you choose. They're both basically unison, so you can make your selection out of the low end of the neck here or the middle of the neck here. I'm going to maybe go with the middle of the neck here, and in a range, what I'm going to do is follow suit with the musical alphabet. So there's my A, B, I'm going to use the C here, there's a D right there, an E, an F, here's a G, and then here's another A. So I've just found my whole layout from what I drew on the music staff into a range of the guitar neck, which it locks down on. So it's a great exercise. It only takes a minute to do, and you'll be able to start relating the notes on the music staff directly to your guitar fingerboard. I still have another exercise to go over with you, but I wanted to take a minute to let you know that if you need to learn more about playing guitar, like chord patterns and the key signatures, then I'm going to make you a great offer. With any donation over $5 or any merchandise purchase from either my Teespring or my Zazzle store, I'll send you a free copy of 3 of my most popular digital handouts. One is called Harmonize Arpeggio Drills. It's a great handout on training the development of diatonic arpeggios, some great fingering and exercises there. Another one is my bar chord handout. If you don't know your bar chords, this will be super helpful. It also includes a page showing all the key signatures along with a chord progression exercise that actually applies the bar chords. Plus, you'll also get one of the best things I got around here. It's my notation pack. It's 8 pages of important guitar worksheet paper that you need for notating anything related to guitar. Music charts, guitar chord diagrams, tab, it's all in there. Just send me an email off the contact page at creativeguitarstudio.com to let me know about either your donation or your merchandise purchase, and I'll email you those digital handouts within 24 hours. To take this exercise one step further, I'd suggest either on the same day or on the next day of doing this exercise, you pick another range for locating the same tonal name. Now, what I mean by this is,
See, we started with the note of A and we located it on the music staff from the mid-range area. Then we went to the guitar fretboard and we located that A note off of the fourth string, seventh fret, and built a scale there. So our next level of work would be to take that same note of A and begin once again over on our sheet of music staff paper and plot that A tone out from another register. I'm going to build it now from a lower register. So just like before, start with one note. That note will be the primary tone. We'll use the lower range note of A. That's the one on the second ledger line below the staff. And from that note, we'll ascend through the other seven tones of the musical alphabet and we'll write all of them down on our piece of staff paper. Now, underneath, write their names and over top of the notes, write their numbers from 1 to 8, root to octave. Once you have the notes written on the music staff, the next thing to do is locate those notes on the guitar neck. But when you're doing this, remember that the music staff is a representation of the range of pitches. So if we're using low range tones, those lower tones will be in the lower strings area of the guitar fretboard. Let's use the neck generator over at the Guitar Scientist website once again to lay out the low range tones that we wrote on the music staff for that A note, and we'll get those notes placed onto the fingerboard as well.
Now let's do our other range with the Guitar Scientist generator here. And remember, our first range was more in the middle of the music staff, so we were finding those notes in the middle of the neck. But our next range that we went through was down lower, starting on some ledger lines of the music staff. So what we're going to do now is grab at some of these lower A's. So we could take that A at the 6th string 5th fret, or we could even just come at it from by way of the open 5th guitar string. Both of those notes are unisons, they're the same. So what I'm going to do this time, instead of staying in a position like we had done previously, is I'm going to move laterally along the neck and set everything up that way. So I have my A moving to B, to C, to the D, then an E, an F, a G, and then up at a higher A. So this time I went laterally, just went all along the span, horizontally along the guitar fingerboard. I've got all those notes that I was looking at on the music staff off of that lower ledger line starting point, and now I've got them on the guitar fingerboard. So it's just that easy. This is a very simplistic exercise. It's great for taking notes from the music staff, bringing them onto the guitar fingerboard, building your awareness, not just for how notes relate to a music staff, but also how those notes are being laid out and situated onto the neck.
Well, you know, if you want a quick guitar neck exercise that only takes a couple of minutes a day to do, then this one is fantastic. It's not complicated. There's no technique to learn to do it. You can be a total beginner to do this. And the best thing is you don't even really need a guitar to do this, just a sheet of music staff paper and maybe access to the internet. But the benefits of what you get out of this exercise are well worth the couple of minutes that it takes to do it each day. You'll obviously get a better handle on the music staff, the use of the notes, but also what's especially good is that you'll gain a better comprehension for where notes from off of a music staff go and correspond onto the guitar fingerboard. The notes that we use in this example are actually from the scale of A natural minor, but going forward, you can use other keys and other scales and take this exercise to a whole new level, one that helps you nail down all types of guitar scale layouts and ideas. Plus, you can even use it to memorize all your major and minor key signatures as well. Guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, then head over to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.
When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com.
I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.